I never knew about agriculture. I never heard the word before.
I probably thought of like the typical, the sheep says baa and the horse says nay kind of thing.
Right away, probably a big red barn with livestock.
When I thought like a farmer is like a person that just got like a lot of open space.
Someone who's harvesting crops.
A person with a beard.
He has a long beard and a straw hat.
Farmer has meant this thing that other people do in a particular place, and I think that's part of what's changing.
We're in a really exciting time when we think about agriculture in really redefining what it means to be engaged in agriculture.
Winter is the time for us to plan for the rest of the season. There's constant activity around care and feeding of the animals. And also really getting ready for the spring plantings. Howard Buffett says that each farmer only has 40 seasons within their own lifetime to learn from. And yet, if we collaborate, we have the potential of hundreds or thousands of lifetimes of experience to apply to our decision-making for the next season. I'm the research director here at Wolf's Neck Center for Agriculture and the Environment. It's 600 acres of farm on Casco Bay. I'm also a farmer, and my background is in natural resources and earth system science, and particularly the study of open source technology and using technology to connect with the environment. Some of the challenges that we're facing in agriculture is to produce more food in a changing climate. We have an unprecedented ability to restore and regenerate a lot of the landscapes. We use a lot of open source technology, Raspberry Pi computers to Unix operating systems to basic sensor design and networking. All of these things build on one another. We have the potential for every farm, every backyard to essentially be a personal research farm. To grow food where it was not being grown previously.
The mission of Mars Farm is to grow plants on Mars. If you look at Mars as a testbed for ways that we can improve agriculture on Earth, it's hard to see a correlation between the two of them. But that's only because on Earth, if you throw a seed outside, there's a decent chance that it's going to grow. What that experience really keeps you from seeing is that's not the optimal way for that plant to grow. We, as Mars Farm, designed and built the MVP, or Minimum Viable Product, food computer. Encapsulate that into almost a formula to grow a plant and generate recipes so that anybody could grow any plant anywhere given they have the proper environment. We do that specifically by providing kits for teachers to grow plants in their classroom with their students. There's many versions of the food computer out there. With some of the more advanced food computers, not a lot of people were able to build them. Some of these sensors can be hundreds of dollars just for one sensor. What we tried to do with the MVP is really pare it down to the bare necessities you need to get a decent amount of science that anyone can build. Through our open source project, there have been at least 100 different groups who've built our food computers. You think of the expense of owning 500 acres and a combine, it's a multi-million dollar small business. That's not easy to enter. The average age of a farmer is 58, and that's a big area of talent that right now is gonna be leaving the workforce. We see, though, the biggest impact we can have is by educating the future generation.
That feels too far forward.
A farm bot is basically a robotic farm that you can do from like your house or other parts of the world. So we were trying to make a sequence that when you plant, we're trying to get seeds that can be planted by controls, and a sequence that plants seeds for us. And it's pretty difficult, but we got it.
Aquaponics is where you use fish to help spread bacteria in the water and help other plants grow.
Aquaponics turns out to be like a really natural way to produce more food faster.
One group is time-lapse, sees the plants and how fast they can grow throughout time. And another group is working on sensors for the plants.
In the United States, the obesity rate is high. Our business is to create the food computers and provide them in different elementary and middle schools so that kids can have the mindset of choosing healthier food.
I'm picking up stuff in Baltimore. Chris is doing stuff in Long Island. Chantel's doing stuff in St. Louis. Everyone kind of like sees different challenges in what they're doing and is picking up on these different solutions based on open source technology.
So we know that today we're going to kick off our hydroponics.
What was a really great opportunity was meeting a bunch of like-minded educators who were doing similar things. And we said, why not have our students sort of trade that data with one another? Let's talk about what we're growing, why we're growing it.
Today we planted our seeds in the garden.
Hoy plantamos unas semillas en el jardín y lo que estamos plantando es lechuga.
The sharing of all the ideas is so important because, one, it levels the playing field.
This is where you guys just introduced. Hey, here's who we are, here's where we live, here's what our project's about.
Yes.
Oh, wow.
And what I wanted to point out,
this global world into reality, so it doesn't feel like such a large world, that there's ways to reach out and kids can see beyond where they live.
I think creating ways for everybody to essentially engage in asking these agricultural questions is really profoundly important. We can become better farmers by sharing our knowledge with one another and create a points of intersection that transcend cultural boundaries between rural and urban environments.
Students have to look at open source and problem solving and engineering and things and say, well, I'm not gonna wait for what the future has in store for me. I'm gonna direct where I'm gonna go in the future.
Agriculture and the food that's produced should look like the community that's producing it.
So this whole idea of what a farmer is gonna change. It has to change.
Before this class, I never really looked at what we did as called like farming.
It was like an eye-opener for a lot of us, including myself.
Kind of never expected like a farmer to be like mostly like technology.
A farm can be anywhere. It doesn't have to be in this big field that's empty. It can be in your own house. A farmer could be anyone.
And so I do consider myself a farmer.
I want to grow plants to sell to the public.
I kind of want my community to truly change about the way they eat and like the way that we live.
it's so amazing to think like that it doesn't matter what season, we can always have a food source.
We're all coming together to help solve problems that are really going to be important when we inherit the world.